I think I can. The funky engine that could.
Ooh. Yowski wowski, peasky weesky. All aboard the Stankonia Express. The underground smell road. Everybody's looking for an excuse to let loose. What's your locomotive?
It's a place and a state of mind. The place is right here. The studio that we're in is called Stankonia.
Right.
State of mind is like a butt-naked state where really you just strip yourself down to,
mm-hmm.
to like starting back over like a baby,
mm-hmm.
and then going in the studio with no kind of, actually no kind of instructions at all, you know, and just picking up all the different toys and making sound.
I mean, that's what makes the whole album just sound like it's just everywhere, and like, but it all blends in because, I mean, it's the styles that we use and all the especially the sounds that's intertwined in the songs. And, man, I ain't never heard nothing like this before in my life, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm just glad to be a part of it.
The first single off the Stankonia album, it was done while we were on tour doing the Quimini album. It was done like, the production was done like in the back of the bus. And as soon as the beat came out, we knew exactly, you know, that it was gonna be the first single.
Like most of the time, we always pick our first singles like way ahead. Like that'd be the first thing we record on the album or whatever, just like Rosa Parks. So B.O.B. was done right after we did Aquemini.
It had to be like really like powerful. And the hook says, don't pull the thing out unless you plan to bang Bones Over Baghdad. Don't even bang unless you plan to hit some Bones Over Baghdad. So it's kind of like a chant, letting everybody know that we're not playing, we're not trying to play at all. Miss Jackson is most definitely symbolic of every baby's mama's mama. You know, it could have been Miss Bartholomew.
Yeah.
Miss Johnson. You know, it could have been anything, but Miss Jackson just fit real nicely, you know, rolling off the tongue.
In relationships, you got relationships every day, you know. So just letting people know, I mean, you might have one set of dreams and think it's gonna all work out this way. But just because it doesn't mean that you and the person who you're involved with or in the kid or whatever, you can't still raise your kids and still have like a working relationship with your child's mother, you know what I'm saying? And also respect the grandmother.
Humble Mumble.
Right.
That's the next single after Miss Jackson featuring Erykah Badu, right. Which is Miss Jackson's daughter.
Not right.
But now it's like, that's kind of like Calypso type of funk jam.
Yeah, and it's basically the song talking about, you know, once again, dreams and you know, the theme of this album is like dreams and how your dreams can be shattered, but you can still recover and come back or whatever. It's just like, almost like just because you get down doesn't mean that it's the end. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's all about striving and struggling to get to where you want to go.
The whole album is like a collage of different pictures, you know, but when it's all put together, it's like really, it blends in really nice. Everything kind of like gels. But like Big Boy said, every song is its own dimension, own experience. So it's not like you're getting a whole bunch of like sound-alike type songs, you know?
Yeah.
Something on there for everybody, you know, like a little buffet table.
Getting more and more deeper into the music or whatever. Like when we first started, we were just writers and MCs, you know what I'm saying? And then after Southern Playlistic, we were producers, we started producing. And then, you know what I'm saying? Now it's evolving into different things, like picking up instruments, you know what I'm saying? So now it's just like, I guess that's like the natural thing to do when you really love it. We came out on a Christmas album.
So we tried to make the best Christmas song ever.
I mean, people just dug it and it caught on. And then it was like number one on the rap charts for like 6 weeks. And I mean, it was just doing good. And then it gave us the opportunity to go in and make Southern Playlist again.
ATL, as I would say, it was kind of like a more thought-provoking album.
It was growth too. Like, on the producer side, you know what I'm saying? We got to express ourselves on both sides of the fence, on being the lyricist and the producer, and just really just sitting down and then working on the complete songs by ourselves. We came in the game, we didn't know how to do that, like produce, and just to be able to learn, and, I mean, just I love it.
I guess that was all like, okay, we finally getting comfortable with what we're doing. Mm-hmm. And so it's kind of like more like a celebration. More like, okay, we freaking it. We're gonna go and freak it now, you know. It wasn't like tiptoeing. We, you know, we in now, you know, let's do it. Yeah. Wasn't really thinking about it at all. You know, as you get older, you get into your own mode, your own set, and you start seeing that happen on Quimini.
Rosa Parks was a song Like, we just described it, the hook was like, aha, hush that fuss, everybody move to the back of the bus. You know what I'm saying? So it's like everybody, same thing that's going on now, music was going on like back then when we did Aquemini and when we called it Rosa Parks. So we was like using that as a, like, everybody move to the back of the bus, like, y'all do that, but we gonna be like Rosa Parks and we gonna sit up front though, you know what I'm saying? And we gonna do this music right. So that's all that symbolized. Some kids didn't even know who Rosa Parks was until, you know what I'm saying? It's like we take it upon ourselves to teach as well as entertain, you know?
Yeah.
We want the listener to go on a journey from the beginning to ending, you know what I'm saying? From track one to track 17 or whatever. And just listen, you know? I mean, that's how we try to make our albums be like soundtracks for life. The name of our group, Outkast, we don't never want to be categorized. I mean, we stress individualism and, you know what I'm saying?
All day long.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, the whole non-conformist way of living is like what we dig. Have your own flavor. Make your mark in this world as you, like, express your art, because you're only going to be here for a short time until you go to the other place, you know?
Yeah, this one right here goes out to all the babies, mamas.